Where is the legislator who will courageously rise up to protect every single preborn baby in our state? We are searching for Wilberforce. I had an amazing conversation with Representative Erin Grall of District 54 on September the 20th. She is endorsed by Florida Right to Life, and she attends St. John of the Cross and St. Helens Catholic Churches. These are the statements she made during our conversation. People often call themselves certain things until they have to stand up for them. Everyone has the right to life. I want to be as strong as I can be on an issue. After we discussed the five tenets of abolitionism, she said, "I agree, although there are challenges to the practicalities of politics. The climate of our culture is due to the legalization of abortion. I personally don't believe in abortion in any cases. All life is precious. Life is my one issue. Without it, nothing else matters. How do we get to where abortion is no longer acceptable? I don't think there are enough people with that kind of courage." This is why the dismemberment ban bill was very difficult for me, because it required the extermination of life through alternative means, because those other procedures are more humane. That's not at all consistent with how I view life. These children are not going to show up on the steps of Tallahassee to plead for their own protection. Please know that I struggle with all these things. I have a spot saved for a life bill. How do we do something that's meaningful? We will study the abolitionist bills that were filed in Texas and Oklahoma. We will consider it all. I hope I'm not the only person who attempts to take on this topic. We really need men. Men run away from being the ones to carry this type of legislation. What the media, the left, and women have done to men who speak up for life is egregious. We make an appeal to you, Representative Grall. Remember Deborah and trust in the Lord, and act according to his word. He said, "For the eyes of the Lord run to and fro throughout the earth to give strong support to those whose heart is blameless toward him." Even if no one goes with you, the Lord will strengthen you as you set your heart to do his will. To you and your staff, to St. John of the Cross Church and to St. Helens Church, to all the constituents of District 54, repent and seek the Lord with us by God's grace and for his glory. The time for justice is now.